Okay, just like Grand Positive Clock say again, with this is a very vague flowchart. You have a much more detailed flowchart in your shared Google Drive with me. Sorry, that's my dog barking. He's being a pain in the buttsky. But anyway, just like Grand Positive Clock say, we're going to have gram negative rods. And just like gram positive cocci, we had an enzyme test called catalase, remember? And then depending on the catalase, it was staph and strep. Now we have another enzyme test called oxidase, remember? It always ends in A-S-E when it's an enzyme. So we're going to do a quick swab test. And if the oxidase is positive, it means it's Pseudomonas. And the only Pseudomonas you guys know of, which I already talked to you a few slides before, stop it, Bradley, is Pseudomonas aeruginosa. If the oxidase test is negative, that means it's part of a huge family of gram-negative rods called Enterobacteriaceae. And the nickname is Enterix, which you'll see in a few slides. But the one you already know about, excuse me, is E. coli. I'm trying to eat my dinner as I do this. Sorry. So, again, by doing an oxidase, you can tell if it's a Pseudomonas, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. If it's negative, that means it's part of the Enterobacteriaceae big group. And the one you so far know we talked about is E. coli.